Good evening, and you're very welcome tonight to our night prayer on Thursday night, the third week of Lent. My name is Helena Connolly, and I am a member of the Redemptorists Parish Mission Team. And tonight, leading us in prayer, I'm joined by Father Paul Turley, who is coming to us from Clonard Monastery in Belfast, and Sister Betty Baker, who is a Salesian sister from Limerick, representing the Limerick side of our ministry tonight. So it's lovely to be joined by both Father Paul and Sister Betty. We, like every night when we come together for prayer, we light a candle. And tonight we have a special prayer intention, as we do each day. And today's prayer is for refugees and for those who are displaced. So we pray for those tonight in a special way, those fleeing from war, from conflict. And we pray, Lord, that refugees can find protection and peace instead of fear and anxiety. Lord, accept this candle as a sign of our faith and love for you. So during our prayer this evening, we will have moments of silence. So just to make you aware of that, during these moments, please just take your ease, allow the words that you've heard just rest in your heart. And a reminder just to write your prayer petition, your intention in the comments as you watch live here this evening. We'll read some of them aloud. If we don't see them, just know that maybe we could all pray. If you do see those prayers come up, we hold all of the prayer intentions, everyone that's joined together. So we just bring all of those tonight. We unite them together. So we begin our night prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, come to our aid.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
My body shall rest in safety.
I say to the Lord, you are my God. My happiness lies in you alone.
He has put into my heart a marvelous love for the faithful ones who dwell in his land. Those who choose other gods increase their sorrows. Never will I offer their offerings of blood. Never will I take their name upon my lips.
O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. It is you yourself who are my prize. The lot marked out for me is my delight. Welcome indeed the heritage that falls on me.
I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel, who even at night directs my heart. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm.
And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad. Even my body shall rest in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay.
You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence. At your right hand, happiness forever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
My body shall rest in safety.
A reading from the Thessalonians. May the God who gives us peace make you completely his and keep your whole being, spirit, soul, and body free from all fault at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit.
Thank you for your intercessions. Your prayers have been coming in on the Facebook, the various Facebook platforms here. Just like to pray a few of these aloud now. And there are many prayers that we carry in our hearts. And it's just important tonight to remember those that maybe we haven't put in the comments section. We bring them all now to our Lord. Bernie has asked that we pray for all who are grieving at this time. Just to remember to keep in our prayers those who are sick and to get to look after their family and friends tonight. Seanad would like to pray for Davy McGrath, who is in intensive care, and to pray for Davy's family. Ursula has asked that we pray for all of the sick. And Eleanor has asked that we pray for her husband and for herself and her family. Mary has asked for a very important prayer for many of us who live alone. These times can be very isolating. And just we pray for everyone tonight, perhaps if you're watching alone and feeling that sense of loneliness and isolation, just pray that God will be with you within that space tonight, give you strength and a little bit of hope, maybe just to keep going during this lonely time. Margaret has asked for good health for her family and for a young girl who's lost the power of her legs, that her health will improve. More prayers just for those sick and in hospital. And Teresa has asked for a special prayer for a young woman, Sarah Everard, that very sad story. Just praying for her and for her family and her friends who, while out walking in Southeast London, met a very sad end. So we remember very especially that story tonight and that family. Anne has asked that we pray for her mother, who was born on this day in 1910, and she died on this day in 1993. It's a lovely day to remember Anne's mother and for her sister, Mary, who is 82 today. And thank God, very well and sprightly. Just perhaps one or two others. We pray for Margaret and Mrs. Mackay, who are both ill at this time. That's from Sinead. And Ursula, thanks everyone for their prayers. So we just again encourage you, all of these prayers, just to remember them all tonight. And I'd like to pray for Conchín, that she is blessed with good health in the days and weeks and months ahead. So just for all of those intentions, those that we've said aloud, those that we carry quietly, we'll just present them now to God, and we'll just give a little bit of silent time just to pray, just in the quietness of our own homes and in our own hearts tonight. We also remember that prayer intention for refugees and those displaced tonight. Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Protect us while we sleep, that we may keep watch with Christ and rest with him in peace. At last, all-powerful Master,
you give leave to your servant to go in peace according to your promise.
For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for all nations, the light to enlighten the Gentiles and give glory to Israel, your people.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Save us, Lord, while we are awake. Protect us while we sleep, that we may keep watch with Christ and rest with him in peace. And let us pray. Lord our God, restore us again by the repose of sleep after the fatigue of our daily work, so that continually renewed by your help, we may serve you in body and soul through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord grant us a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen.
And thank you for tuning in, and thank you to Father Paul and to Sister Betty. Beautiful readings, and thank you. It was very prayerful for me, so thank you for that. And also to thank Claire on technical support tonight. So please join again tomorrow and spread the word and just be part of this wonderful initiative, just that we can unite each night together in prayer with the Redemptorists. So thank you for joining us, and we will leave you tonight with a Marian hymn.
So